An elderly couple has told of a terrifying ordeal at sea when their catamaran was smashed by 4 metre waves during a daring voyage from Hobart. Police trekked for hours to rescue the pair who washed up near Mallacoota. With more on this story, we're joined live now by TEN's Yasmin Payton. Yas, you've spoken to the couple. It's an incredible tale of survival.
Certainly is, Helen. Case Rosendahl and his partner Denise Dynan, both aged 75, set off from Hobart last Monday. Now, they were intending to arrive at Eden on Victoria's east coast by the weekend, but 4 days ago, howling winds set in and that caused waves of up to 4 metres to batter the boat. The couple says that during those 4 days, they just held on for dear life. All they survived on was bread and water because they said it was just too choppy to prepare anything else. And they said they just had to literally hold onto the boat with one hand at all times.
And it just came out of the blue, just in a matter of seconds, bang, and there it was. And the rain came, and the hail, and the snow, and whatever, and it became a circus. The boat was screaming and being bashed to bits.
Now, the couple couldn't get any mobile phone reception, but they did manage to get a message to a friend who was tracking their coordinates. Now, he raised the alarm and emergency services leapt into action. The couple was winched to safety late last night after a very brave sergeant from Mallacoota trekked through very thick scrub and treacherous conditions to meet them at a remote beach where the rough seas had finally pushed them.
The sergeant, Mark Truckellis, he was the hero of the whole thing. He walked for 4 hours, 3.5, 4 hours through the bush because it's an impenetrable area where we finished and where we were laying.
It's not the first time Sergeant Tregellis has been called a hero. He was given a bravery medal last year by the Governor General after saving a man's life who was threatening to jump into a fire. So Case and Denise are currently recovering with some hot soup and some hot coffee. They were pretty emotional this afternoon when I spoke to them because they did lose everything on that vessel, but they are hoping it can be salvaged. And Case says that he does belong on the sea and that he can't wait to get back out there.
OK, thanks, Yas. TEN's Yasmin Payton reporting live there.